Water. It has a way of revealing our deepest fears and testing our courage. Whoever thought water would be the bridge between a father and son? That my dad's fear of water will somehow change my life.
One day, Jyotish came to our house. Jyotish, astrologer, came to our house and he said that your son has got ghat of water. Panini ghat che. That means the water is dangerous for your son. And they said that water can kill me. If I'm going anywhere near water, they used to tell me, oh, don't go, you can't go. So fear went inside.
I still remember when I was entering the world of filmmaking, everyone put a lot of doubts in me. And just like how people put a lot of doubts of water into my dad's head, a lot of people put doubts into my head about filmmaking, how it's a risky field of work, field was unstable, that I'll never make it, that it's an impossible dream for me to even try to achieve.
Okay, so one day I said my cousin that, please, I want to see swimming pool. I just want to come with you. And he told, okay, one day. So I was so much excited. So we came, I changed my clothes. And when I was going in a shallow water, I was not able to go. I was so much excited to go inside the water. Everything was okay, but I was not able to. I said, no, because the fear was inside. Water, my parents, someone will tell, and most probably it's very dangerous for me, and I'm doing this, if I'm doing right or wrong.
It got to a point where I was doubting myself, if this is the right path, if what I'm doing, is it the right thing to do? Because I wasn't sure. What if I fail? What if I disappoint my parents? What if everyone is right? And slowly the fears and doubts started to eat me up alive, and I was this close to quitting before I even started.
After, within 2 or 3 days, it was surprising, as my sir and everyone said, that I learned very fast. So even my sir said that you are the first student who learned so fast. So he was teaching me how to dive. And really speaking, I have got fear of height. While I was climbing and I was going very slowly, that I don't want to do it. One thing happened, there was a small child was front of me, and he was very good swimmer, but he also was very much afraid. So I told, okay, you can go. Because I was thinking that I want to go at last. Then he was going, he was coming back, he was going, coming back. That's what I wanted to do. So I was like, go, you can do it. And that, what I was telling him, I thought that someone is telling me to do that. And suddenly that child did it. And when he came out from the water, after diving it, when he came out, he said me, thank you. And then my sir said, come on, now it's your turn. I don't know how I did it, but I took a deep breath and I did it. And then again, I remember the first thing. When I went into the water, half an hour I was not able to do it. That also someone was telling me, the first step is, second step will not be.
I chose this and everything, but I'm not sure if I'll be able to make it. And then he reminded me of that one day where he taught me how to swim. He was holding my hand and I was swimming, and then I didn't realize, but he took me to the deep end and then he let go. And he said, this is the deep end, and if you stop, I'm not gonna hold you. And I was like, wait, whoa, but in that moment, I didn't really have time to think. So I kept swimming, because if I stop, then I'll drown. And when I finally got to the other side, I was tired and I was mad at my dad, saying, how would you do that? That's so crazy, stuff like that, blah, blah, blah. But then he told me something. If just like that day, if I had let fear control me and consume me, then I wouldn't have made it to the other side. I'll face a lot of challenges. And just like his story, that the first step is always the most difficult step, and then it starts to get easier.
Because fear harmed me a lot. So many things I was not able to do in my past also, before swimming. There was lots of fear in me.
Dad facing his fears was kind of like a lighthouse for me to face my own fears. And in a way, water taught us both how to overcome our fears and, you know, just keep going forward.